Hey everybody, how's it going? Let's talk about your home recording studio. Today, we're going to talk about Patchbays. Now, Greg, you'd asked about this a couple times, so it's been kind of at the forefront of my mind recently. So today, we're going to take a look at the 48-point TRS Patchbay that I've got, and it's by ART, or ART, and it's called the P48. It's just all balanced quarter-inch inputs and outputs. 48 on the front, 48 on the back. Now, I've been using this for like several years now, and I've really been using it for the most simple thing that a patch bay can possibly be used for, which is just as a through, just for the sake of getting inputs and outputs that are on the back of devices in my rack, like my interface, you know, outboard gear, things like that. It's no fun to have to go crawl around behind your rack every time you want to plug something in differently. So a patch bay is a great way just to simply plug stuff into the patch bay. All those inputs and outputs are now on the front of your rack, and you can patch things with patch cables. That's pretty much the way I've been using it for the last several years. But I got to thinking about it recently, and I'm just kind of curious, hey, is there a way that I might be able to use this thing to more of its full potential to help kind of simplify things that I do in my own home studio? And heck, figured might as well take y'all along for the ride here. So maybe we'll learn together and learn a thing or two about how we can use a patch bay in our own studios. All right, now on the ART unit here, they have this handy diagram that they put on the top. You can see there's kind of eight different diagrams divided into two sections. This section over here is labeled half normal, and this over here is labeled normal. Now what the heck do those mean? So at pretty much the most basic level, a patch bay is just going to connect anything that you plug in to the rear of the unit. It is just going to automatically pass that signal to the jack directly below it. So these are all numbered 1 through 24 on the top and 25 through 48 on the bottom. And let me actually turn this so it's right side up for you. And there's kind of a convention amongst patch bays that the top row is what you plug outputs into. You send things to plugs on the top row. And the bottom row is inputs. They are things that consume signal. So if you take, let's say, an output from your interface, plug it into, you know, jack number one on the top, on the back, and then plug maybe the input of a compressor onto the jack right below it, numbered 25 here, it's just, with no patch cable on the front or anything, it's just gonna pass that signal straight on through. So you can kind of set up these default routes, and that's one thing that I'm wanting to look into doing as I wire up my rack and everything in this new room. I'd love to see if I could kind of economize on the number of these kind of vertical stacks that I'm using. In my last studio room, I used them all, and I still had a few more devices I would have liked to have plugged into this. So I think I can kind of save a little bit of space by just going ahead and letting the patch bay make the connections that I tend to always make myself anyways. All right, so let's talk a little bit about normal, half normal, and non-normal or unnormaled. Now in normal mode, as soon as you jack in to the top front of one of these vertical stacks, it's going to break the connection that was sending it out the bottom rear. And it's no longer going to do that. Now the signal is only coming out of, is only going wherever you patch it to. And that's in a normal type of a setting. And in a half normal setting, as soon as you jack into the front, it still returns the signal out the back, but it also sends the signal wherever you patch it to. So it's kind of like a mult or like a duplicating the signal kind of thing. So if you have one signal you want to send to two destinations, you would want a half normal setting on your patch bay. Now there's also the setting called unnormal or not normal, Abby normal. This particular patch bay doesn't support that, but the unnormal is basically there's no relationship between the top and bottom of the stack. They're both just purely through. And that's kind of how I was using it, but that meant that I had to put every input and output on a different stack. In a normal or half normal setting, if you say plug the input of a compressor to the bottom of the stack and the output of the compressor to the top of the stack, that's just gonna form a loop, like a feedback loop. And I tried that just out of desperation one time, and yeah, sure enough. You know, the compressors are just, all it takes is some little disturbance in that signal, and that just creates an infinite loop of noise, and it just cycles through there until you unplug it. So if that's really what you want to use it for, you would want to use a unnormaled setting. And some patch bays do support that. Okay, on this particular patch bay, on the rear, the way you control normal versus half normal is just these little push button switches. And I'm not sure how well you can see that there. But if you push them in, I believe that is normal, right? Yeah, you push it in and it's the normal setting. And if you press it out, it's the half normal. So let's start off and let's plug a couple of things in here and let's just leave it in the normal setting at first, and then we'll play around with half normal and see what that does. All right, for this demonstration, I have my trusty interface out of its rack for the first time in a long time. And I grabbed my ART Pro VLA, and I chose this because it has two channels that we can use independently so we can kind of demonstrate patching from one channel to the other. Okay, first, let's start off simple, and let's just patch in channel one of the compressor. Okay, I guess first things first, we're gonna need a little bit of audio to work with. So I've got a mic set up here, and I'm just gonna record a few guitar chords just as an alternative to me just speaking into the mic and you having to listen to me speaking on a loop. That will be really annoying. So let's just record a few guitar chords and get that going real quick. Okay, so first things first, let's patch in an output from the interface to this kind of first stack over here in the patch bay, from the patch bay to channel one of the compressor, out of channel one of the compressor, back to the patch bay, and from the patch bay to an input of the interface. And as you can probably already tell just by me saying that getting a patch bay is definitely going to double the amount of cables that you're gonna need in your studio. Okay. So I've got some balanced TRS cables here, and I'm gonna wire it up just like I said. So let me turn the interface around here so you can kind of see what I'm plugging in and where. All right, so we are going to go. So analog one and two on my interface are already sending the interface's output to another interface so I can record and you can hear what I'm doing. So we're gonna start on output number three. And remember, outputs go on top. Now you don't have to put outputs on top, but it's gonna make it a little easier for other people to understand your rack. And it's also gonna make it behave how you expect when you jack into the front in normal versus half normal mode. All right, so now we're gonna go from patch bay and to an input of the compressor. So this is gonna go on the bottom here. And we're gonna go input of channel one. Now we're gonna go output of the compressor into, I'm gonna put it on number two here. So that's this kind of a second vertical stack here. And my last cable is gonna go into an input of the interface. So it's going on bottom. And we're gonna put it on input number five. Okay, I'm gonna leave it in normal mode. Hopefully I didn't touch that. All right, cool. That's in normal. And that is in normal. And over on the computer, on this track, I am going to add an instance of RIA insert. And I'm gonna tell it to send out analog three and come back on analog five. There we go. So hopefully, fingers crossed, if I plugged everything in right, once I start playing and start dialing down the threshold here, we'll start to see some activity on the gain meter, and hopefully we'll be able to even hear some of that compression happening. Let's see. Yeah, there we go. All right, yeah, there we go. All right, very cool. All right, so now what happens if we want to get channel 2 looped in here. Let's do that real quick. Another 4 balanced TRS cables. So again, hopefully, if I got everything plugged in right, we'll see gain reduction on channel 2 this time instead of channel 1. All right, very good. Okay, so we got both channels wired in through the interface. And we didn't use any patch cables at all. We never even touched the front of the patch bay. So, okay, let's just kind of invent a scenario here. Let's say you've got everything wired up and you got your project set up just like this, where you've been compressing on, you know, channel 1 of this compressor. And let's say either, I don't know, maybe you get a new compressor that you love, or maybe this one stops working or something like that, or just for whatever reason, rather than the default pathway that we've set up just by plugging things into the back here, let's say you want to defeat that and route it somewhere else instead. So right now we're in normal mode. So if we take a patch cable, and let's just go ahead and I'm just gonna let it play. And let's just see what happens. Okay, so we're hearing it. Now as soon as I patch in to the top front of that channel, boom, it stops. Stop completely. There's no gain reduction. We don't hear anything. Now all of that signal is going through the other end. This is now the output. This is now analog 3 of my interface right here. So I can still send, even though I've got this default routing set up, now I can still send analog 3 wherever I want it. So instead, let's send analog 3 into like the input of channel 2, which was here, maybe? Yeah, there we go. So I patched it into, what is that, number 1, 2, 3? Right below 3, so that's 27 on this way. But yeah, you can see, yeah, now we got signal. But of course, we're not hearing anything, and over in Reaper, of course, we're not coming back. Actually, we do get a little bit of signal here, and that is actually just an artifact of this compressor. It's just kind of a known issue these compressors have, the Pro VLA2. There's some bleed from channel to channel, so even though we are technically only sending to channel 2, channel 1 is still hearing some of that, and we're still, our return is still plugged into channel 1. So let's defeat that. And let's get another patch cable. And so let's come out of that compressor of channel 2, and let's send it back to input 3. I'm sorry, input 5. So I believe input 5 was here, right? Yeah, there we go. So now we hear it. And so now, without changing our routing and software or anything, we've just patched. We've overridden kind of the default routing. So now I'm going to continue to let that play. And the only thing I'm going to change here is the normal setting. And I'm going to go to half normal on this first vertical stack here. And let's see what happens. Now, check that out. We see gain reduction on both channels. So that half normal is not only allowing the signal to return to the cable that we have plugged into the back of the unit, but it's also sending that out our patch point. So we duplicated that signal. So it's going to both places now. All right, and as you can kind of see through this whole kind of jungle of cables that we've got plugged in here, you know, we just got so many everywhere. So if you end up with a bad cable. Actually, I was messing around with this last night, and I had a bad cable, and it took me forever to figure out what the problem was. And yeah, it was just, you know, one of these cables finally gave out after all these years, and it was complicated. It took me a while to figure out exactly where the point of failure was. You know, with all we got going on, routing in and out, we got software, we got mixing controls for the interface, we've got, you know, a piece of outboard hardware, we got this thing, and then we got all the cables. And so those are each elements, they're each points of potential failure. and troubleshooting signals and then making sure you got it all plugged in right. You know, your first couple times, I know my first 100 times, 200 times, I really struggled to keep it straight in my mind of where everything was going. I kept a spreadsheet. I just brought up Excel, and I had a couple of different spreadsheets. One that represented all of the points on this patch bay and my other patch bay, which is an XLR. And then another grid that represented all the inputs and outputs of all my different devices. So from either end, I could just read that spreadsheet and know where on the patch bay it was, and also look at the patch bay and know where any of these patch points led to on the backside. It's gonna get complicated, and I highly recommend you write that stuff down, or else you will forget. And next week you come back and you try to start plugging stuff in, and you're like, I have no idea what's going on. And your only recourse is pretty much to get back behind there and start tracing cables and figure out where, you know, what plugs into what behind the scenes. All right, well, I think that's going to do it for me this time. I hope that this has at least been a little helpful. If you're a little curious about whether a patch bay is right for you, if you've always been kind of curious about how they worked and everything, and Greg, I hope that this at least was a tip of the iceberg of kind of explaining what you can and maybe can't do with a patch bay in your home studio. So thank you very much for bearing with me. I appreciate it. That'll do it for me this time, and I will see you guys next time.